Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. The topic that I am going to discuss today is plaque hybridization. In this video, I am going to discuss two things about plaque hybridization, namely, first, principle to plaque hybridization, and second, procedure involved in plaque hybridization. The technique of plaque hybridization is somewhat similar to colony hybridization, which is also called as screening of genomic library. I have already made a video on colony hybridization. I have mentioned the link of the video in the description, so please go through it. Now let us understand principle to plaque hybridization followed by its procedure involved. If you are new to my channel and you have not yet subscribed, subscribe my channel and press the bell icon so that you can get all the latest updates of my new uploads. Benton Davis in 1977 developed plaque hybridization. This technique is applicable to where a chimeric phage particle is carrying the gene of interest. In such a situation, a bacterial lawn is infected with a mixture of chimeric phage particles and large number of plaques develops overnight. These plaques can be treated just like the colonies in colony hybridization to identify, isolate the chimeric phage particle carrying the gene of interest. Now let us understand its procedure. The starting point for screening is the agar plate covered by host bacterial culture, which is also called as lawn, on which are clear phage plaques. Each plaque contains recombinant DNA of one type. The replica filter is dried and then soaked in sodium hydroxide solution. It has two effects. First, the phage capsids are lysed and the proteins are removed. And second, the double-stranded phage DNA is denatured to single-stranded. If you can see in the figure, there are many steps involved in plaque hybridization. First, plate lambda library on bacterial lawn to produce plaques. It is kept for few hours to overnight. Next step, lay nitrocellulose paper on plate to lift the plaque. Next step, place the nitrocellulose paper on a blotting paper soaked in an alkali solution, which is sodium hydroxide in this case, to form single-stranded DNA and also to remove phage capsids. Then we have to hybridize it with radio labeled probe. Labeled probe solution is kept in heat sealable bag for 24 hours. We have to wash the unbound probe and then it is checked by autoradiogram. As I have already discussed that the technique is similar to colony hybridization, so please go through my video on colony hybridization which I have already uploaded. If you are watching my video for the first time, please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon so that you can get all the notification of my new uploads directly onto your phone. Thank you.